So we have some really great news this morning. So if I can start first with Southeast Queensland. We only have 5 new cases. 1 is detected in hotel quarantine, and 4 are local community cases, but they're all in home quarantine and they're all linked to that Indooroopilly cluster. So that's fantastic news. That's the sort of news we want to wake up to. So we now have 12,364 people in home quarantine. We have 153 active cases. We've had 26,394 tests in the last 24 hours. So again, good testing numbers. But of course, Queensland, we've got to keep that up. We absolutely must, if you have any symptoms whatsoever, please go and get tested. And Queensland Health did over 3,500 vaccines in the last 24 hours. And in Cairns, we don't have the private testing numbers back yet, but we have 971 tests that were done yesterday in Cairns, which is fantastic. Now, Dr. Young has also informed us some very good detective work in Cairns overnight. So they've actually linked the taxi driver with the marine pilot. So the marine pilot actually travelled in that person's taxi. So a lot of contact tracing is now happening, of course, with those exposure sites, but it's great to know that linkage has been done. So honestly, great work by our Queensland Health staff. Fantastic news there. So look, I know that Cairns is in that 3-day lockdown and we hope that everyone is doing the right thing. It's really important if you're in Cairns to be staying at home and only going out for those essential purposes. So we want to make sure that we get all of those contacts from the taxi driver into home quarantine as quickly as possible to keep that community safe. And I know that the Cairns community will step up, just like the Townsville community stepped up when they had to as well. So I congratulate everyone for doing the right thing there. And of course, Queenslanders in the southeast of those 11 LGAs, please make sure you have a look at that roadmap and please continue to do the right thing. It's really important to be checking in. We're using your check-in app. It's important to get tested if you are feeling sick. And of course, now the high school students are wearing masks and I thank them all for doing that. And from all reports from education, there's been no issues with the distribution of masks there. Okay, Dr. Young will also address, there's been some questions about community sport, and it does include not just school community sport, school age, but it also is adult community sport as well. So it's the next 2 weeks, but she'll address that. Now, I want to talk to you about some good news about where we're standing today, and of course, that's the Brisbane Convention and Exhibition Centre. And what we're doing is we're opening this as a mass vaccination centre, which will be starting this Wednesday. So we're getting a sneak preview today. And thank you to the staff here for being so quick in setting it all up with Queensland Health. Now, the federal government is responsible for 70% of the vaccination of Queenslanders. Queensland government is responsible for 30%. So what we do know is we're getting on some of that, that Pfizer is going to be coming on faster over the next couple of weeks. So from Wednesday, this convention centre will be open from 8:30 till 4:30. And we are now asking people, if you are between 16 and 59, you can now register on the Queensland Health website. Now, of course, a lot of people will still be going to their GPs or the pharmacists to get their vaccine. I've just heard, I think, that the Commonwealth Government has also approved Moderna, so we'll be getting more information about Moderna. But this is a great centre here for people who are already on that waiting list from Queensland Health. You will be prioritised, but as we work through that list, now we are opening it up for anyone between the ages of 16 and 59. And on top of that, there'll be free parking here as well, which is fantastic. Now, please, don't just turn up. This is not walk-ins. You must be registered and you'll be contacted by Queensland Health. But we want to see as many people in Queensland vaccinated as quickly and as safely as possible. So there are now additional options that will be open. So that's fantastic news and we're looking forward to seeing this open, and it will also be open 7 days a week and it'll be open on the weekends as well. So please hop on that website today, register, make sure you do it, do the right thing. You're not only protecting yourself, you're protecting your family and you're protecting your community. So with those few words, I'll hand over to Dr. Young and then we'll do some questions afterwards. Thanks. Thanks, Dr. Young.
So excellent news overnight. All of our cases were in quarantine during their entire infectious period. So that one person who returned from the Philippines and went into hotel quarantine tested positive, so we're all used to that. And then our four community acquired cases related to the Indooroopilly cluster, who were all in home quarantine during their infectious period. One of those, so I'll go through those four cases. One of those is a staff member at the Ironside school. So we're still seeing first generation cases. We all have to remember that the incubation period is 14 days. So it's really important that people, all of those 12,000 people, do stay and adhere to that quarantine as we go forwards. Then one was a parent related to a child who attends Ironside. Another is a household contact of someone who attends Brisbane Boys Grammar School. And the fourth is another household contact of someone who attends Ironside. But the important thing to note is that the incubation period is 14 days. And unfortunately, that means that anyone who's in home quarantine, if they become positive, that entire household then has to remain in quarantine for another 14 days. So this is a lengthy process that we all have to work together to get through. Now there are some, there have been some questions, I'll put it that way, raised about community support. Now it's really important for the next 2 weeks that people do what they did over those 8 days. So just think, is this really necessary? So if you're questioning whether you can do something, then probably you can't. So for community sport, it is fine for up to 10 people to gather in a public place, but you must wear your masks, you must keep social distance, and you can't come into contact with people. That's really, really important. So if your sport is one that involves contact with other people, then it can't go ahead. But if it's golf or tennis and you've got a small group and you maintain that social distance and you wear your masks unless you're strenuously exercising, then it's fine to go ahead. And the same with indoors. If it's a dance class and there's no contact between the dancers and there's one person, maximum one person per 4 square metres, that's fine. So, and then people have asked about bridge. Well, the same thing. If you've got, you can have up to 10 people in your home. We know that. Or if you're going to a commercial venue, you can have one person per 4 square metres. So people have done this so well, and I'm sure they can sort out going forward what they can do in terms of community sport. What I don't want to see is kids from a whole lot of different schools all coming together, because we know that that led to a significant part of this most recent outbreak that we're still working through. We had that karate class, for instance. So it's really important that people use their common sense as they've done so beautifully over the last 8 days. And this is for the next 2 weeks, while we just make sure that we don't have any cases that are out and about in the community, because we're only just started to have those days of zero cases infectious in the community. That's really important for Southeast Queensland. Then for Cairns, it's vital that you are now in lockdown for 3 days while we work out all the contacts of this taxi driver and we go back and reassess all the contacts of that pilot who brings ships in through the reef. So clearly we've found on whole genome sequencing that the taxi driver acquired it from that pilot. We suspect it was when he drove that pilot from his home to the airport and that pilot then flew down to Brisbane. So we're just going back and checking all of those contacts and just making sure that we have all of them. So it's really, really important that people in Cairns, any symptoms at all, don't wait for a call from Queensland Health. just come forward and get tested. And the numbers yesterday were magnificent. People did exactly that. So thank you very much. It's really important going forward so we can find if there's any other clusters of cases or any other chains of transmission so we can manage them as quickly as possible. Then down in the Gold Coast, we do have that one case down there who did test positive. So for the Gold Coast, it's really important that you also, any case, any symptoms at all, please, anywhere in the Gold Coast, come forward and get tested. And that's really important to do today as we just work through what the risks are from that particular individual who came forward so quickly to get tested. So all of those things just need sorting, but the general message, of course, remains the same. It doesn't matter where you are in Queensland. We have no idea where this virus is next going to pop up. So please, any symptoms at all, don't think it's your normal hay fever or normal whatever, just come forward and get tested. So we had 26,000 people do that yesterday. Earlier last week, we had over 50,000 people. So please, it's really important we continue those numbers. Thank you.